Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student-athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student-athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
Welcome to our live coverage of the Class 4A Championship game here on the Indiana Cable Network. We're down to the final game of the day, and the Panthers of North Central and the Tigers of Warsaw High School will be going after each other for this 4A Championship. Hello again, fans. Jerry Baker alongside Dan. We're just about worn out as we just watched an overtime game, and I'm just thinking back to Monday, Dan, when the coaches that I talked with, Doug Ogle of Warsaw, said, you know, I'd like to have a game in the 40s. It's not going to happen, is it?
Well, so would Doug Mitchell, but that's for a half. Doug Mitchell wants to score in the 80s. They average 78 points a game. They play 11 players, and you're right. Doug Ogle, the coach of Warsaw, he wants it in the 40s or 50s.
All right, Dan Dockich and I will be here for the rest of the evening. Hope you will, too. Let's take a look at the tournament trail here and show you how these teams got here. North Central winning the Lawrence Central Sectional and the Hinkle Fieldhouse Regional. They only had to play a couple of games there. That Noblesville game, by the way, was an overtime game. And then they beat Jeffersonville in the Southport Semi last Saturday. Average win margin just under 10 per game. They've got any number of players we could highlight, Dan, but let's go with Terone Johnson.
Well, you're right. They do have a number of guys, but Terone Johnson headed towards Purdue. Does everything for this basketball team. Most important thing he does is not score 21, Jerry. Most important thing he does is lead and get the guys, you said it, 11 of them play, get those guys organized on the court for Doug Mitchell.
Right, the Tigers of Warsaw come in here having also played only two games of the sectional. They beat Concord at Elkhart Memorial at Elkhart Central, and then they defeated Merrillville. Then they beat a very good Munster ball club by 9, 40-31. They went to the Huntington North semi-state, beat Carroll of Fort Wayne, also a very good club by 5. They have really had to struggle here to get to the state finals. Their average win margin in the tournament's less than 6 points a game. Nick Moore, one of the best little guys you're going to see all season long.
He really is. He scores, he assists, he rebounds. Most important thing he does is he controls the tempo of the game. He is Doug Ogle's coach on the floor.
So I guess it's speed versus pace of the game, and it's whoever has the better will, I suppose. Huh?
Once again, huh?
Yep.
Once again, we saw it early, we just saw it, and now here we are again, same scenario.
All right, we've had overtime. Who knows what this one's going to have for us. 4A championship game, North Central, Warsaw, next on the Indiana Cable Network. Well, there's a look outside at the traffic. Running by Conseco Fieldhouse. A beautiful picture tonight, and we're back inside now. And a sellout crowd, capacity over 18,000 on hand. I made comment of the 3A game, Dan, I thought this looked like an awfully good crowd, and the official word is it's a total sellout. But the North Central Panthers at 24-3 getting set to go against the Tigers of Warsaw at 23-2. Let's get to the Selborne knee setter keys to the game. We'll start off with what will be the visiting team, North Central.
Well, North Central playing 11 guys. They get to offensive rebounds. Not at the rim, but those 50-50 balls. I'm going for it. You're going for it. If they get 15 or more, pretty tough to stop. Also, 10 or more steals. When you're a pressing, trapping, quick team, you want at least 10 steals in the basketball game. For Warsaw, they need to establish a pace that, as you said in the opener, Jerry, Doug Ogle, the coach, he wants it in the 50s, maybe even the 40s, and more for more. We talk about scoring, we talk about assists, all that, but it's going to be the leadership, stopping the runs, calming the team down, being, as we said earlier, the coach on the floor from Nick Moore.
Dance keys to the game presented by the folks at Shelbourne Knee Center. We've got a break, then we'll get the starters and the tip-off for the 4A championship coming up next. We come inside Conseco Fieldhouse. This is Jerry Baker along with Dan Dockich and the rest of our IHSAA network crew. And let's take a look at the starting lineup for the North Central Panthers. They've got a bunch of terrific players. Terone Johnson, one of the guys we featured a moment ago. Devontae Smith-Rivera, young man coming on strong. Darius Latham in the middle. And then Ronnie Johnson and Micah Smith. And as we also referred to, they will go very deep in their roster because they are full court from coast to coast right from the opening outset of the game. The lights, of course, are out here at Conseco Fieldhouse for the introduction of the players.
Jerry, this is the first freshman we've seen in the starting lineup, the Latham kid.
And to get into the starting lineup at North Central is no easy task, by the way. As we pointed out, they will go very, very deep in their roster. As contrary to Warsaw, they will not go that deep. And I thought it was really telling when Doug talked to me on Monday. I said, where do you want to keep the game? And he said, I'd like to keep it the 50s. And then as I started to react, he said, maybe even the 40s. It's going to be almost impossible. As I referred to early, it's like playing, when you play North Central, it's like playing in a hornet's nest because they just buzz at you from every conceivable angle.
And that's exactly right. You pass them, next thing you know, somebody comes up from behind. You think you're by one guy, here comes the next guy. You over-recover, bam, the next guy comes and tries to backbite you. You are absolutely right. Doug Mitchell's team, a lot like Gary Roosevelt, a lot like Bowman, they're going to play hard, they're going to be tough, and they're going to be disciplined.
Here is your starting unit now for the Warsaw Tigers with Clemens, Lucas Groves. If that sounds familiar, his father, Jeff, was a terrific player of the tournament a few years back. We'll talk more about that. Dan focused in on Nick Moore. I have not had a chance to see him play yet this year, but from every avenue of information coming our way, this kid is really something special. Jordan Kuhn and Zach Linky will round out the top five starters as they go with a three-guard starting lineup to the Warsaw Tigers coming into this game.
Nick Moore's a kid. You remember Jason Gardner, the kid who was so terrific at North Central, had an outstanding career at Arizona. He's one of those kind of kids, Jerry. He can handle the basketball, dominate the game with his ball handling. He scores, he picks up loose balls, he rebounds, he assists. He's only about 5'8", 5'9", but he is a terrific all-around basketball player.
Let's take a look at the comparison of these two ball clubs statistically, at least on paper, give you some indication as to how they will shake out. 78.5 points for the Tigers, for the Panthers, 60.1. Points allowed, 54.8 to 49.9. I don't know really, Dan, that those numbers mean anything right now.
No, I don't think they mean a thing other than what you said about Doug Ogle at Warsaw trying to keep the score in the 50s. That's what they average. They've gone through a season playing that way. They don't want to change just because they're in this stage against a team like North Central.
In fact, Dan, one of the last things after he said I'd like it in the 40s, one of the other comments he kind of threw away in my direction was, that doesn't mean we're going to stall. In other words, he was saying we're going to run an offense that's perhaps time-consuming, but certainly not a stall offense.
Well, you have to make a choice, and this is where I talked earlier about the leadership of Nick Moore. If a team's going to press you, you have to make decisions on when to go to the basket, when to speed up, take chances, or when to simply back it up and run, as you said, a deliberate, not a stalling offense.
Well, I would assume for the opening tip-off they will turn the lights on. That has not happened just yet, and we apologize for...
I guarantee you these kids have shot a lot of basketballs in the dark.
Yeah, it's probably true. But I don't think we want to play the 4A state championship. There we go. Not digging the ball. All right, again, North Central, the 24-3. The North Central coach has been around for a long, long time. Doug Mitchell, 17 years at North Central, 286 and 124. A terrific guy and a very, very active coach along the sideline. He's very intense. Now to the Warsaw end of things, Doug Ogle, a 120-59 record in 8 years at the school. He befriended John Wooden back at 03, said he spent about seven different times he's visited him in his Encino, California home. You think he picked his brain a little bit?
If you're going to have a friend in coaching, not a bad guy.
Not a bad guy to have. Here are the refs, Ron Day, Tony Ortman, Mark Hopper. We're coming off an overtime 3A championship game, which Washington won over Gary Wallace, and just a game that really just sucked the air out of this place, I'm telling you.
Energized it, gave it to us, and then took it away in the end.
It was a terrific ball game, and it's one of those things, I know it's trite, but you wish both football clubs could have won.
Yeah,
it's just
kind
of a game it was. Right now, with the in the white uniforms, will be Warsaw. They are the home team by virtue of being the North representative. You get it inside and miss the gimme shot, and the ball comes off into the hands of Delonte Smith-Rivera. He's the top rebounder, and he won't have a lot of boards, only 6.1. Outside shot by Devonte Smith-Rivera is off the mark. So they spread the rebounding around pretty well. No one guy has double digits. Put up jumper's a beauty, and there he is.
Boy, you can see right now, Nick Moore fast with the ball, ball on a string, head up all the time.
Nick Moore getting his first 2 points of the game. Ball almost thrown away, save. Here's the three-pointer in the sky. Long rebound taken off by Warsaw. They average 29.8 rebounds a game. They out-rebound their opponents by only about 7.5 per. They give up 22-2. North Central averages 37 rebounds per game, and they allow 29. So the rebounding advantage would be in North Central's favor right now.
Well, Doug Ogle wanted a slowdown game. He forgot to tell his players.
Apparently so. You don't think he would josh with the media, do you?
But he would. Everybody's honest in coaching with the media.
Absolutely. Minute gone, first quarter of play. Open look on the near side, Ronnie Johnson. And the rebound yanked off in the middle by Lucas Groves, only a sophomore at 6'5". Turnaround shot inside, banked it in. It's Justin Clemens getting his first two, and it's 4-0.
Terrific pass by Nick Moore. No-look pass, we have a travel.
A turnover by North Central. This is not the way, I can assure you. And Doug Mitchell wanted things to start tonight.
Watch a no-look here. Boom! Slipped right between two guys. Great hands by Clemens. Clemens' dad, Gordy, was a terrific basketball player, an All-American at Franklin College. Clemens' dad, Gordy's going to be mad at his son for that pass right there out of bounds.
Did they talk about that, that whole family there? And one of the references they make is that mom might have been a better player than any of them.
I don't think anybody that's a male in that family would agree with that.
4-year starter is Clemens, son of former players, Dan mentioned Gordy Clemens, the brother of former Tiger Colin Clemens. All three of the Clemenses played on sectional championship teams as seniors. Here's the jump hook off the mark, and it'll be out of bounds. And a foul away from the ball, and they are looking at Warsaw's Jordan Kuhn.
Let's see what they got. Kind of a late whistle here.
Yeah, it is on Kuhn. It'll be one on him.
A little bit fuddled by that. Not the first time. Nice crossover in the lane.
Oh, that's a good-looking shot, and that's Devonte Smith-Rivera. Only a sophomore.
That's his game, Jerry. Strong built, nice crossover, low to the ground.
And a foul called against North Central, and the foul's going to be on Justin Clemens, number one on him, two against the ball club. I'll check it. That's on Micah Smith.
Well, Nick Moore's going to have to get used to that because that's how they're going to play him. They're going to be all over him. They're just, if somebody gets in foul trouble, we're going to bring somebody else in.
Baseball pass up court into the hands of Nick Moore, and they get it inside and get the layup. Nice play by Justin Clemens, his second bucket, 4 points.
Clemens took it out, ran the floor, knowing he could get it back because that's what Moore does.
Back to the four-point lead again. In the middle, struggling to get it, was Gross, and it's a traveling violation. I was talking about Clemens. Gordy said that his wife, Dana, I'm going to correct you here,
okay,
is the best athlete in the family. She was a three-sport athlete at Westfield High School, starting in basketball, volleyball, and track. Pulled down 22 rebounds in one game. Did you ever have 22 rebounds in one game? She's got you.
Yeah, that was in the summertime. We're playing at Draper's Court. He must have been in trouble, Gordy, to say something like that.
Absolutely. He knows what it's like. Smith-Rivera got the bucket at this end. At the other end, they turn right around and get it back. And Lucas Groves picks up his first bucket. Now three of the starters for Warsaw have scored, and the Panthers turn the ball over.
Boy, Nick Moore right now, Jerry, right from the get-go, playing at a high, high level. Playing fast. Watch here. Just fast down the floor. Great touch. And look where that pass was. The pass was right there to Groves.
Nick Moore, 5'9 junior. He's played in 24 of their 25 games. He averages 21 points. He leads the ball club in assists and steals. So he's not just a shooter and a scorer. Here he is, pull up 17 footer. Is it air ball? He was looking behind. He thought the defenseman was coming right up on his tail. Didn't get there. 8-4 now in favor of Warsaw. Smith Rivera off of the corner to Justin Clemens. Attack it to Micah Smith. And once again, they come up empty at this end of the court. Really, really pressuring Moore, and they make the steal. Here's the breakaway now by Johnson. Ronnie's got it. Ronnie gets his first 2 points of the ball game. A couple of Johnsons on the team, Terone and Ronnie, and they are brothers. A lead pass up court to Lucas Groves. He got behind the defense and gets the bucket. This is not a 40-point pace here.
40 points in the quarter.
Yeah, man. This is not not what we expected. Shot, no good. Rebound, Jordan Kuhn.
Wow.
Rebound, baseball pass up court off the fingertips of Gross and out of bounds.
I'm not sure I've seen a guy, Jerry. I'm not sure I've seen a guy that's more fun to play with than Nick Moore. He gets a turnover here. Fine, Ronnie Johnson goes ahead and gets a steal. But when you have the ball in your hands as often as Nick Moore does, you're going to have a turnover. But boy, does he play with his head up. Is he fun to play with? He will find you. You better have good hands or he's going to hit you in the throat.
You're looking at Andy Conrad. He just came off the bench, 6'1 senior for Warsaw. Jalen Roscoe, a 6'2 junior, likewise off the bench for the Tigers. Now a sub for the Panthers into the lineup. Patrick Ingram, 6'2 sophomore, coming onto the floor. Now another change. Diedrich Griffin, a 6'4 junior, will be in the lineup for North Central. We pointed out North Central will sub freely. They'll go very deep in their roster. Warsaw, not so much. But they have already substituted the first two of the game.
Just had the first shift change.
That's right.
North Central. Yeah. That's all that was.
4.5 to go now in the opening quarter. North Central in the dark uniforms. They are the visitors. By virtue of the way the draw was set up, the Southern teams are the visitors. Another turnover and a traveling violation. And that will be the fourth turnover of the game already on North Central in the first 3 minutes and 40 seconds.
A little impatient here. Driving from the top of the key is fine once the ball's been reversed a few times. But when you straight drive from the top of the key, the defense is already there. You convert yourself, four guys convert.
Nice pass that time by Moore, and then he got it right back. They double him out high. He'll get the wall up in the corner. The long rebound comes off into the hands of Terone Johnson. Johnson going coast to coast, puts it up and scores. Terone now with an average of 21.3 is the top scorer for the Panthers of North Central High, and the ball is out of bounds. It'll go to North Central.
Something very interesting here on the inbounds. Really smart by Doug Mitchell. Took two players and double teamed. Diedrich Griffin was one of them. Took two players, Diedrich Griffin and Patrick Ingram, and double-teamed the inbounds on Nick Moore. If nothing else, going to wear him out.
Timeout with 3:58 to go here in the first quarter. It's 10-8 now. Warsaw leads North Central to the 4A championship contest. Jerry Baker along with Dan Dockett and the rest of our crew tonight. Delighted to have you along on the 4A championship game. And Dan and I were talking at the outset of the contest, setting you all up for a slower-paced ball game.
I think Doug Ogle lied. I think he lied to you, Jerry. 40-50, come on. This team is ready to go.
That's a little strong. I won't use that phraseology, okay. But let's just say that he had a twinkle in his eye, and I didn't pick up on it, I guess. So far in the game, shooting is 56% for Warsaw. And North Central just having a little trouble just hanging on to the basketball right now.
Yeah, a little miscommunication between Tripp McFall and Tim Bass. Two kids just into the ball game for the first time. What's that, 20 guys?
Not quite 20, but we're going to get there, I think, before the night's over. Here's that lead pass up court. And knocked away. Good defensive play from behind that time. Nobody contact that I can tell. No official with a hand of the air. No, here it comes again. Here's this defense.
Yeah, great defense. You'll see the ball gets blocked here and comes down on the guy out of bounds. I think it's Bass.
Griffin comes in from behind to make a little contact, and now the official stops play. We got a sub for Warsaw. Justin Clemens will come back onto the floor, and they will take Jalen Roscoe out of there. I think one of the things that Doug Ogle is going to want to do, I'm just guessing here, Dan, is he's going to want to sub as much as he can just to keep his guys fresh. Absolutely. With the pace of this ball game.
No question. He'll sub. He'll sub around the one TV timeout that happens each quarter. I don't think he'll go to zone. Told me they're strictly a man-to-man team.
3:35 to go now in the first quarter of this contest, and it's been nonstop right from the get-go. Into the lineup, Tim Bass for North Central. They're making changes. There's Conrad. They get it down inside, and they match scramble. The ball goes out of bounds, stays in the possession of Warsaw, and with this dead ball, in comes a couple of more subs for the Panthers. They will reinsert Terone Johnson. And for Warsaw, here comes Jordan Kuhn back into the lineup.
Remember the first game and last game, we were talking about the great bodies, the great basketball bodies of Roosevelt or Wallace, the great basketball bodies that we saw. This game, kid like Clemens, not necessarily a great basketball body, but unbelievable feel this kid has, and terrific, terrific hands.
Here's the foul being called against Griffin. That'll be number one on him.
The boys would have to get used to that. They're going to bang him, try to wear him out. Right there, they did it again.
Here's the steal. Getting up court, McFall. Trip McFall is almost like a sixth starter. In fact, the story is interesting that Doug went to him before the season and said, man, we're going to bring you off the bench. He said, fine.
And you know, that's really rare in this day and age. Not only was it fine for Trip McFall, it was fine for his parents. It was fine for everybody involved. Doug made a special point of that. I know at your Monday press conference. He also did it with me later on in the week to praise that kid and his attitude with this basketball team.
He's a 6'3 senior in 26 games, averaging 5.5 points and just under 3 rebounds per. At the free throw line, he's a 67% shooter, hits the front end of the two shots. And don't forget now, for every free throw made today, Taco Bell donating $10 up to $500 to the IHSAA Centennial Scholarship Award. Two of them right there. 10-10 tie for the first time. Warsaw has had the lead as high as 4 as they came out of the box in a hurry, and a foul on McFall. It's the first on him.
That's the first foul on McFall, but it's the fourth foul against Nick Moore. You know what I mean? I mean, they're banging him, they're bodying him. That's the fourth time he's been fouled in this basketball game. Fourth time, you know, and that doesn't include the grabs and things like that.
Backdoor cut, nice looking play, and a great defensive effort turned in by Ingram. And they're going to call a foul. Boy, he got a lot of basketball. Ingram with the first.
You know, Doug Mitchell doesn't like it. He did get all ball, but on the replay, came down on the arm.
There's Doug Mitchell, graduate of Hamilton Heights High School and Butler University. He's got to be pretty proud right now. Likewise, in fact, he was the recipient of Butler's 1979 Hilton U. Brown Mental Attitude Award. He was a 6-year assistant coach there likewise. Moore gets the first one.
Just got a neat text from Brad Stevens. I text him telling him how people here at the state finals are really going crazy. And Brad is so cool, right? I mean, Brad is just such an easy guy. Here's his response. He just won, went to the Final Four. Hey, that's so cool. Thanks, Dan. You know, just.
Well, he's only just won himself a right to go to the Final Four. He's got time to talk to us. Come on. Two good free throws by Moore. And you know what? And my comment to you is, that's part of what makes that program what it is.
Absolutely. And it's not only him. It's Barry Collier.
Yes.
It's the assistant coaches. You talk to Gordon Hayward, all you do is come out, impress Avery Jukes, Ronald Norrin, all those kids. Unbelievable group, unbelievable culture in a basketball program.
You know, I have to go by near the campus on my way home after the game tonight. Should I kind of detour a little bit around that area, you think?
No, go right in the middle.
Go right in the middle of it.
Go right in the middle.
I don't think so.
I think I
will. Left-handed shot by Smith-Rivera. Half a dozen. Yeah, you got to go that way also.
Yeah. So.
There's a tie ball game at 12. There is that Butler score as they beat Kansas State. Kansas State was a number two seed. In fact, I thought after some of the others got eliminated that they might be a real contender. Oh, strong move by Smith-Rivera.
Smith-Rivera, only a sophomore. Really strong. Watch this here. Watch the scrum. Well, you missed the scrum here coming out again. Pretty good decision in transition. Smith-Rivera, great jump, good base. Led with his right shoulder. Watch this here. He's going to lead with his right shoulder, extend, keep his head on the basket, and that's key. To make a shot and keep your chin on the rim.
Justin Clements picks up the foul. That's number one of the 6'3 senior. And now we'll look for the three-point play. Smith-Rivera, 73% of the line, gets the roll. It's a pretty good shooting free throw team. Both of them shooting, I said that. Then I took a look. North Central only shoots 64% from the line. Warsaw 70% from the free throw stripe. 2.5 to go now, first quarter. Kind of settled things down just a bit. Warsaw coming down from about 120 miles north of Indy. Got a crowd of around 13,000 population, and I think every one of them's here today. Here's the turnover. Here's the lead pass. Here's the bucket. Nice looking play up to Diedrich Griffin. He has his first two.
Ronnie Johnson, number three, just made that pass. Fun kid to watch. Has a great feel in transition. The crowd is booing because Nick Moore got banged again before this play right here. Ronnie Johnson leaves his feet, no look. Good finish.
5-point lead now for North Central with 2 minutes and 2 seconds to go. The pace of this ball game has been breakneck right from the opening tip-off. Both coaches have had to substitute freely. Doug Ogle, 8th year at the school, record of 120-59, and we mentioned that Doug Mitchell in 17 years up on the north side. This North Central school is one of the largest in the state, 4th overall behind Ben Davis, Carmel, and Warren Central. Roman of just over, well, right around 3,400, 3,393. Chuck Jones, the athletic director, one of the super ADs. Does a lot of stuff for hosting various high school IHSAA events at his fine facilities up on the north side. They just completed a brand new natatorium up there.
It's beautiful. So,
yeah.
I've been to the tennis facility, Tennis Hall of Fame.
Terrific, yeah. Less than two to go now here in the opening period. 17-12, North Central was down by 4, and now suddenly they've surged ahead with a 5-point lead. Here is Moore, and they are really coming after him. And a steal inside. This time the steal by Griffin. Over go the other way, coast to coast, off the glass, nothing doing. Three white shirts inside, battle around. Momentarily, Griffin had it again. And now off into the hands of Lucas Groves. They got numbers on the other end. Let's see if they can turn them into anything. Spin move at the baseline by Clemens didn't develop into anything. And the loose ball picked up by North Central again. Smith Rivera in a hurry. Micah Smith, cross court. And a foul from behind, and they're going to get Nick Moore this time. Nick.
That was as crazy and up and down as I've seen.
Yeah, it is. There's no way to even describe it. Just let it go.
Just let it go is right. You know, you mentioned the substitutions. Okay, we're 7 minutes into the game. Already Ronnie Johnson, Micah Smith, and Tim Bass have taken turns on Nick Moore. Now, there's substitutions. People think, well, we sub a lot. Well, there's a method to Doug Mitchell's madness. He's going to keep a fresh guy on Nick Moore. And what he's telling him, when Nick Moore gives up the basketball and starts to make a cut, step in front of him. They're being very physical with Nick Moore. And again, they're going to run three guys. To this point, it's three guys. They can always move Smith Rivera, sure, somebody else with a little bigger body if they want to as well.
Smith Rivera completes both of the free throws. He's 3-for-3. The ball club as a whole is 5-for-5 in the opening quarter. And the lead goes back to 7 now at 19-12. This is something that Warsaw, Dan, cannot afford to happen. They cannot dig a hole because they can't get out of it.
They absolutely cannot. And when it was going bad, Doug Mitchell just sat there because he knew a run like this was coming.
Final minute of play in the first quarter. Sellout crowd on hand at Kachiko Fieldhouse. They had just witnessed an overtime 3A championship game that was just something to behold. One of the most physical games Not to say it was dirty by any stretch of the imagination, just a real man's basketball.
Darn right, just a tough, aggressive, hard play. You said it, man's game.
Open Smith, nothing, rebound, inside. I'll tell you what, Lucas Groves is doing a good job inside, only a sophomore.
Yeah, he's a big, strong, tough kid.
Well, they are all over goal.
And again, got him again.
I guess they're figuring, Dan, if he's only 5'9", a junior, maybe they can wear him down. I have a feeling he's like the wind-up bunny. You're not going to put wear him down. This is not pretty by any stretch of the imagination. Long shot. That's going to take care of things in a wild and woolly first quarter. And North Central established itself after trailing by four. They will go to the end of the first quarter up by seven. Here in the 4A championship game, it is North Central of Indianapolis 19, Warsaw 12 on the Indiana Cable Network. Not the prettiest of first quarters of play here at Conseco Fieldhouse. At 19-12, your score at the first quarter stop. Let's get to the stats now for the first quarter. Take a look at these numbers. Shooting is not good, and partly because the whole thing seemed kind of ragged out there.
It really did. You know, we were talking, well, you just kind of sit and watch and let it go. Doug Mitchell came out to complain at the end of the quarter, and he didn't know where to go, Jerry. He was like what we were saying. It's just, come on, what, where? And then he just finally gave up, went back in the huddle.
I was looking down at the list of notable alumni from North Central High School, and one of them, it says here, Mitch Daniels, the governor of Indiana. And I looked down to your right, and lo and behold, there he is.
Don't blow my cover. I'm supposed to be working for everybody, remember?
Hello, Gov. Nice to have you here.
Good.
Well, he had nowhere to go, so he turns around and gets the bucket. This Terone Johnson, second field goal for him. And now we'll get a foul. They're going to chase Nick Moore until he drops or somebody drops
they,
out there
they
anyway.
Absolutely have to make that call, Jerry, because it was getting out of hand, in my opinion, with what they were doing to Nick Moore. You know, Doug Ogle, he looked at his players. He said, listen, we teach you don't leave the ball with Terone Johnson. Terone Johnson started pivoting. Next thing you know, no one was there, and as you said, just knocked it
Mike,
in.
Micah Smith with his foul. Hey, Gov, did you play any athletics at North Central?
Yeah, I was a wrestler and played a year of tennis.
So the wrestling has come in handy in your job as governor of the great state, then,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's highly reminiscent, yeah.
Governor Mitch Daniels with us down here. And, of course, Bart Peterson, former mayor of Indianapolis, likewise a graduate of North Central High School. 9-point lead for North Central, and they are just about, Dan, you get the feeling like they're about set to establish themselves in this game.
Yeah, they're about ready to explode.
We're only a minute into the second quarter, but you can kind of sense the way things are going. They're just sort of doing what they want to do so far. Here is Ronnie Johnson in the corner, missing the shot. Rebound up into the hands of Zach Linke. And a foul. Governor, you and I were together about, what was it, a couple of months ago when we had the start of the 100 years, 100 days?
Right.
Been a terrific 100 days, has it not?
How about today?
How about today?
How about today? Four great games out here. I went out and caught the Butler game right off campus with a couple hundred students. And maybe you just heard the Kentucky score. So there'll be a blue and white team at the Final Four, but it will not be Kentucky.
What? We did not hear that.
West Virginia beat them by seven.
You know, I filled out my bracket like everybody else. Within a day, I was dead.
Jerry, I got to tell you, I had Butler in the Final Four.
No way.
I did.
No
way. And I've been
way.
Saying every day on my show.
No way.
Absolutely.
No way.
Have I ever lied to you?
No way.
It's true. There's the freshman Latham.
Here is the score. The governor's right on. West Virginia beats the number one team of the land, 73-66. You know, West Virginia's a pretty darn good basketball team, but I didn't think they'd beat Kentucky. That's pretty good.
Nobody was playing better in the NCAA tournament than Kentucky. Although somebody's playing better than Kentucky, it's West Virginia.
Obviously. Here's Latham at the line.
You guys are the experts, but as far as I can tell, Butler just beat two teams that are better than whoever they'll play next.
You know, I felt that way a couple of games ago. I really did. I thought, okay, that was a game that they could have lost. And the way things were shaking out, I thought, this doesn't look too bad. Now here's another foul as they are all over Nick Moore. And this time the foul will be on Patrick Ingram, and that'll be two on him.
That's the fourth guy that has taken a turn on Nick Moore today. And clearly that's Doug Mitchell's objective here. Keep after him, switch bodies, get different people. This is a bigger body now in Ingram. And again, bang him. If he gives it up, bang him. If he has it, reach in there.
Governor, it's also a night, I don't know if you heard it, I announced a while ago, sellout crowd tonight. Terrific to see 18,000 plus here.
Now it's been huge.
Whoa. Whoa. All right, a little damage here. Monitor down. Let's see. Don't show that picture. It shows the back of my head.
I tell you, Dan, I thought I was going to have to be your sidekick the rest of the game. I thought Jerry was headed for injured reserve there.
Okay, show the replay. Yeah, Matt John, that's a boy, Dan. Yeah, that's good going, Matt. By the way, Matt, I have no stat monitor. I have nothing out here. We've got a...
look alive there, Baker.
You notice that's your coffee, by the way, all over the... Or your soft drink or something.
A little pop somebody had.
You know, things were going well till the governor got here, and they've kind
things
of fallen
smooth.
Apart here.
What's up, fellas?
I told you that. I told you I had to do this.
I'm going to push the button and see if the stat monitor will come back on again.
Referees are working. I didn't know people can do this for you. You got your feet.
Oh, yeah.
Where's those little kids with those brooms you see at the Pacers game? Now it's going to be sticky.
We just lived through an overtime game that sucked the wind out of both of us. And now we're over here dodging.
Right, who's on him now? Micah Smith. A little double team. They pressured him, had their hands on him. All he did was get lower. What good guards do, just get lower, get stronger, lift up, knock one in.
You know, I got a feeling you can beat on Nick Moore all night long. It's not going to affect him.
Absolutely. No question.
And they move inside to Darius Latham. Latham gets the bucket, makes it a 26-14 ball game, a 12-point lead now for North Central. Well, you can't, here's the handoff inside, good-looking pass to Rivera, 13 now for him. And we're going to get a timeout by Warsaw, because you get the sense, the Doug Ogle senses, this is a critical point of this ball game. We'll take a break. 14-point lead, North Central. They are right now doing exactly what we have seen them do all year long. They just don't let you catch your breath. We have a moment. Dan and I were talking. We got the final eight, if you will, here. And next week, we get the final four coming to town.
It's going
to
be the greatest one ever. I mean, we had a group from CBS here talking all day about what basketball means in Indiana. They're, of course, going crazy that they're going to have the Butler story now. This next week should be something we'll always remember.
And then, of course, in a couple of years, the Super Bowl coming to town.
Well, you know, we don't think anybody does events like Indiana and Indianapolis.
And the reaction, Governor, that you get when you read in the paper or here on radio and television from the various and sundry outside people, they are always very praiseworthy of our situation. They love the hospitality, and the facilities, of course, are second to none.
Well, I've been talking to some of these visiting coaches. Coach Weber from Illinois here, Coach Smith, and they got Coach Williams up there somewhere. I told them, we want them to feel it, that we're showing good hospitality, but we're tired of them taking our players away. So, like, enjoy the visit, but go home empty-handed.
Go home empty-handed. That's not very governor-like, I can tell you.
Tell you what is it? Butler has 13 Indiana kids on their roster.
That's another reason to love that ball club right there.
Yeah, there's a lot of reasons.
I don't know if you heard, Governor, but Dan had texted Brad Stevens, and he turned around and texted him back. That's the kind of guy he is at, as far as the coach is concerned.
Yeah, he's unbelievable with that. I mean, he is so good. He's what you see is what you get, and I mean, smart. I said on a radio show, national radio show, I think he's the best coach in America.
What you see is a water boy. What you get is a fantastic coach.
That's right. Gross inside, missing on the left-handed shot. Rebound comes off into the hands of Orso, but stolen away. Good-looking play down low by Jack Altes. And they run the break beautifully. They get the ball in the hands of Terone Johnson. He's got to have a dozen.
See, I disagree with you about Brad Stevens. I think what you see is a stone cold mastermind.
Yeah, and no, I was just kidding about how young he looks.
So. Yeah, he does. But boy, oh boy, you watch him on the bench, you look at his eyes, man, he is attuned, and his team is attuned to him, and he is attuned to the game. But you're right, looks like he's about 8 years old.
Oh, nice no-look pass down along the baseline of Devontae Smith-Rivera. Having a night, and once again, Doug Ogle says, I've seen it up. 4:53 to go now in this first half. And an 18-point lead for North Central as we take yet another break here at Conseco Fieldhouse. The 4A championship up for grabs. It's all in the hands of North Central at the moment. I mentioned there's an awful lot of fans that have come in from the city of Warsaw and, of course, from North Central High School, and it's just a few miles up the road. And right now it's all North Central. Dan, they have outscored Warsaw 13-2 in this quarter.
Yeah, and you know what? It's been terrific interior passing. Ronnie Johnson has made outstanding decisions. So has Micah Smith. They've gotten the ball out down in conversion. We talked about their pace. That's their pace. And while they're playing at that pace, like Lou Wallace, they make terrific decisions.
Moore getting inside. We'll get the bucket and draw the foul. Nick.
Governor, you kind of reacted earlier when I said it's about time they called a foul against Nick Moore. You saw him getting beat up here earlier in the game.
Yeah, well, I mean, they've really been letting him play. I would say, I haven't been here all day, that's been the pattern, but you've really seen it in this game. And but he doesn't back down, does he?
Jerry and I were saying, you don't know how to describe it. It's kind of a ragtag frenzy up and down the floor. That's how North Central wants to go, though.
I'm sure there's a set play occasionally that's been run, Dan. I've just missed it.
I'm your analyst. I've seen two. Now here's the zone.
And they go
in
inside.
Interior passing, Jerry.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Look at that.
And the bucket by Terone Johnson.
He's staying in town, Governor. He's going to Purdue.
That's cool. I know.
Yeah.
Gross back nice, again. Nice oh, move. Beautiful move.
You
nice move by Lucas Gross for his first 2 points in the quarter. Half a dozen to ball.
Remember his dad, of course.
Absolutely.
Very nice guy. Still lives up around Warsaw.
In fact, he's in politics up there right now, Governor. He's on the some board of the city in some factor.
I think you might be right. He's a great high school ball player.
Yeah, Jeff, we're talking about. Good looking three for Moore. That's what they really need right now. He is the top 3-point shooter. That's his 49th of the year and the first of the game. He has scored 7 of the 9 points they have put on the boards this quarter. And they've all come in the last minute or so. That drops the lead down to 34-21. And they get it right back at the other end from Terone Johnson, who has 9 points in the quarter, 11 in the game.
That's what you're supposed to do when you're going to Purdue and you're a senior in the state finals right there.
Well, they almost
nice
got
save,
it
Governor.
Again,
hey, ever since the governor came
you
here.
You know, it's like a magnet down here.
Brought you boys a little action.
Oh, yeah. No kidding. Everything was comfortable. You got here, Gov.
You're going to see that for 4 years in West Lafayette right there. Terone Johnson, strong built, nice mid-range game, but he can step out and shoot the three as well.
Is it my imagination, or does he have that sideways spin like Tim Hardaway?
Got a little global spin going on.
Yeah. As long as they go in.
Yeah.
3.5 minutes remain here in the first half. North Central on the doorstep a while ago, putting this baby away. They led by 18. Warsaw's been a little bit of a run, and a big-time foul inside. Micah Smith got tangled up, and we'll pick up his. I've got him down for 3 already, and that is going to be the 3rd on Micah, one of the starters.
Governor, if you want to get people to a rally you're having in Warsaw, like have a high school basketball game involving the Tigers. Look at this crowd behind
us. Oh, it's unbelievable.
It'd be a good night to rob a bank in Warsaw.
He said that, not me.
Yeah.
He said that. That was the governor
of the great state of Indiana.
I'm just saying.
I was talking to some of the guys that they
sold 4,000 tickets in 2 hours.
That's unbelievable. I mean, and they're all here. I mean, everybody.
It's a town of about 13,000. Inside they go, and here is Tripp McFall getting his first field goal. Of course, Warsaw is the orthopedic capital of the world, home to the first orthopedic device manufacturer, and that's back in 1895. And now the number of companies have made their headquarters up there. Less than 3 to go in the first half. There has been not much semblance of any kind of a run down the floor and call play number three. It's been back and forth right from the opening tip off.
Well, you see here, Nick Moore, who is just absolutely a terrific basketball player, really fun to watch, and smart. The shot fake, jumps in, goes and gets a foul. Pretty impressive kid, isn't he?
He is. He reminds me a lot, if you saw the Farrell kid from part two earlier today. About the same size, very, very fast.
Yogi?
Yeah.
Another good game. I mean, we've been sitting here, Jerry and I have, trying not to screw up really good games.
Just get out of the way.
How about that Wallace game, Governor? I mean, two teams, Cody Zeller getting knocked around, guys diving on the floor.
That was a great game. And Zeller is something else. I mean, forget double-double. He had a 20-20 game. 25 rebounds, I think.
26 of them, as a matter of fact. Yeah, which tied the record, by the way, all time.
And Jerry Hall, who used to be married to...
Mick Jagger. No, not the same one.
No, I didn't know.
Yeah, she could really sky there, right?
2.5 to go now in the first half.
Oh, he's strong. You know, one of the things that Warsaw is doing wrong defensively, when you play defense, and you're going to see it here, a bad angle on the ball, when you play a driver like a Smith-Rivera, your shoulders have to be squared to his shoulders, and you have to back off. You can beat by the 3-5, but you can't give an angle, Jerry, in the gun. You cannot have a foot extended, because if you do, just looking at Smith-Rivera's body, he's so strong, he gets inside you, and you can't recover to that.
Only a sophomore, by the way.
My guess is he's had that body a long time. I remember him as an eighth grader, guys were talking about him, and then last year he was terrific for Doug Mitchell's team.
In fact, I remember last year, Doug, and I may not have the context exact, but he said, I'm sure getting tired of talking about a freshman. Yeah. But the way he was playing, you had to talk about it, because he was a major player last year.
Yeah. Came right in, right away, first game.
And we talked about it for free throw. Here comes Warsaw again in the white uniforms. They try to get it down low and could not. That Gross got it out high. Now here they have the ball in the hands of Moore. He'll fire the three. Couldn't get the roll. Over the back foul, Devontae Smith-Rivera. And that'll be three on the sophomore we were just talking about.
Well, this is a key time. You're down 18. You have 2 minutes to go. There's going to be a few possessions. You know, people always say, well, if you can get it to 10, I don't think they're going to be able to get it to 10 by halftime. But if you can make a little dent, 12, 14, before you go in, the number is important. But the feeling you have that you've cut this is even more important. And then, of course, the first 4 or 5 minutes of the second half becomes the key to the ballgame. But you have to cut into it here. You have to make these free throws.
Lucas Groves had 28 points against Lafayette Jeff, as the governor was talking about. It's the son of Jeff Groves, who was second on Warsaw's all-time scoring list with 1,751 points. Led Warsaw to the 84 state championship. He was Mr. Basketball back in 85.
Governor, when you were at Norton or Central, did they have that nice tennis facility?
No, but they had the program, which turned out so many fabulous tennis players for a long, long time. I think the facility came a little after the Stone Age when we were there.
That's a terrific facility. The Hall of Fame is there.
Yep.
Yeah, we were talking about Chuck Jones. I think it was Arlen Licklider was the athletic director there for quite some time.
Todd's dad was the basketball coach when we were kids. And Todd was, you know, the gym rat running around picking up the balls for the varsity.
Gross comes off of the defensive board. Less than two to go now here in the first half. Pull-up shot by Moore. Over the back. Foul's going to be on Gross. That'll be number one on Lucas. Again, a sophomore. They start two sophomores in their lineup as Warsaw, and a 23-2 ball club that holds ball in the future.
You know, it seems like every year Warsaw's good. It seems like every year North Central's good. The future is never bad for those two teams.
Well,
you know, it's a little like Washington.
They just start. Well, yeah. Of course, you got one guy you're building on there, but they seem to build around various and sundry different personalities.
They do, and there's such thing as culture in high school basketball, and Warsaw has always outrode going back when he was doing things with Jeff Gross. I mean, just a tremendous culture there.
That's the same thing in football. You know, sure. you start looking, okay, why is this team so good? Because there's a structure there that says, I want to be on the football team, or the basketball team, or the tennis team, or whatever the case may be. North Central will hang on to possession of the basketball with a minute 32 to go now in the first half.
I don't think Nick Moore is used to having people catching from behind like that. It's a little quicker team than he's probably been playing against,
yeah.
Don't you think?
That's a very good point.
That's a great point. And there's three guys that can catch him. Probably more than that.
Well, that is smooth. Aaron Blewett coming off the bench, a 6'3 senior, getting his first 2 points of the night. He averages 5 points and a couple of rebounds per game. And another steal. Ronnie Johnson couldn't get anything to happen. The foul's going to be called against Warsaw's number 21. That's Zach Linke. That's the first on him.
I think it's going the other way.
Is it going the other way? It sure is. Linke got collided that time with Trip McFall. And McFall will get the foul. That'll be two on him. Took the one off Linke, put it on McFall. And Zach will go to the line, 18 of 21 on the year from the free throw stripe, 6'2 senior. Third on the ball court of assists. Governor, we only got a minute 10 to go. Thank you for coming by. This has been just a terrific year for our city, and it just continues to get better and better and better for the state.
Well, just think about this next week. Next weekend's going to be crazy with Butler here, and, you know, you believe in miracles?
Listen, if you're not going to use your tickets, no, that's perhaps out of line. I apologize.
No, it's not. If he's not going to ask for them, I am.
Yeah, I'm not. You are, right? Basket by Diedrich Griffin, his second field goal.
I just want to know who's going to defend you guys against flying basketballs when I'm not sitting
well,
here.
Well, they'll probably go away when you go away. That's going to be the issue. Thanks again, Governor, very much. Governor Mitch Daniels, a graduate of North Central High School. And things settle down just a bit. Less than a minute to go now here in the first half. And Nick Moore's at the line, getting the front end of the two shots. Moore's having a nice second quarter. Thanks again, Governor. 9 points in the quarter. He scored 9 of the 11 that Warsaw's put in the books here in this quarter. Five out of seven from the stripe. Inside a minute, 44-25. Favor of North Central. The ball club to put points on the board big time. They average almost 79 a game. Warsaw at 60, and we pointed out, Dan and I did earlier, one of the things that Doug Ogle had talked about, he wanted to keep the game in the 50s. Well, that's obviously not going to happen. You just simply cannot run with this North Central team. They have too many bullets in their gun, so to speak, from an offensive scoring standpoint. They've got half a dozen guys they can go to. Here's the little teardrop that falls for Terone Johnson. Johnson having a terrific second quarter. 11 points in the quarter, 13 of the game. They throw it away with 8 seconds to go. North Central gets it, gets the layup, misses the shot. Gross had it momentarily, and a foul from behind. This is not at all the kind of game Warsaw wanted to get into tonight. The foul will be on Diedrich Griffin. That'll be the second foul on Diedrich, and we'll walk to the other end. And Lucas Rose will go to the line where he's 0-for-2, 60% shooter on the season. Double bonus now for Warsaw. Front end of the free throw, no good. Half a dozen for Lucas, averages 9.1. He's the top rebounder on this team with an average of just a shade under 7 per game. One out of two. And thrown away with a second and a half to go now here in the first half. It's really been a sloppy first half of basketball, to be perfectly honest with you. Now through the long length of the court pass, it's picked up by Gross. He will get the shot away, and I don't think it would have counted had it gone. It would not. We've hit the halfway mark, and it has been all North Central to this point of the contest. And Dan Dockage is now at the end of the floor, and he's got Doug Mitchell. Dan?
Coach Mitchell, I noticed as the game was started, your team wasn't where it needed to be, but you never panicked. You knew this run was coming.
Well, you know, you just got to stay. We have to stay with what we do, and that's pressure.
Nick Moore's a tough player. Looks like you decided, well, I'm going to run guys at him. Ronnie Johnson, Micah Smith, that type of thing.
I figure he's got to get more tired than four of our guys, you think, sooner or later. He's a tough customer. He really is a good player. We got some pretty good players, too, Doc.
You've got some great players. Good luck in the second half, Coach. Back to you.
Okay, Dan, thank you very much. Halftime score, again, is all North Central. They're up by 20. That is their biggest lead of the game, 46-26. 4A championship is on the line. North Central leads Warsaw, the Indiana Cable Network. Out on the floor right now, the Red Gold IHSAA Sportsmanship Award for the 2009-2010 winter season. Being presented, created to recognize the outstanding efforts of individual schools to promote good sportsmanship in their schools during each of the fall, winter, and spring seasons. In conjunction with the IHSAA Student Advisory Committee, which received information directly from the IHSAA member schools, Red Gold pleased to recognize Fishers High School as the recipient of the Red Gold IHSAA Sportsmanship Award. One of the things that the IHSAA really high on is sportsmanship, and Red Gold proud to be a sponsor of that particular aspect. And we'll have another presentation coming up shortly. I'm going to have to go through, Dan, as they hand us a stat sheet and update my own score sheet that I try to keep during the game, because the chaos got me a little bit confused out here a while ago. And then when the ball came over here and you ran for cover, that didn't help any either. So.
I didn't think you noticed that. I was protecting the governor.
No, I got
you. I was protecting the state here.
I got you.
Put myself in harm's way.
Well, now that the governor's gone, perhaps that won't be an issue anymore. We were fine until he got here. Now let's pick up the public address system, Scott Gray.
It's through investments like these that the IHSAA is able to continue and strengthen the championship experience for all our student athletes. Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and the Indiana Pacers are both presenting sponsors for this 100-year celebration of Hoosier hysteria. Since 1988, Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance has been a corporate partner of the IHSAA, and every year since has presented a $1,000 Mental Attitude Award at every state championship event. Since 2008, this Hoosier company has been the exclusive sponsor of the IHSAA girls and boys basketball tournaments. This past summer, the IHSAA was pleased to welcome Pacer Sports and Entertainment as a partner with their extensive involvement in the 100-year celebration of Hoosier hysteria. Through this association, the IHSAA Sportsmanship Poster Program, the Indiana Pacers are helping student athletes and schools throughout the state. This year, nearly 5,000 posters have been distributed to member schools to stress the importance of being a good sport.
Halftime stories right now. The halftime report brought to you by the Shelbourne Knee Center. Lots of highlights here, Dan.
Yeah, lots of highlights, mostly involving Nick Moore if it's Warsaw, but the 18 turnovers for Warsaw, problematic. Here's one of them here. And again, so many guys doing so many things for North Central. Their practices have to be an absolute blast because guys competing against each other, guys fighting for playing time. You see the layups. Jerry, 34 points in the paint for North Central, 21 points off turnovers, 14 fast break points. Quite frankly, they've dominated this basketball game after about the first 4 or 5 minutes.
Here are the team numbers, and I guess they pretty well personify what we've seen on the floor. I'm a little surprised that Warsaw with 19 rebounds to 18 for North Central.
Yeah, that's a little bit surprising, but, you know, transition points. You get a 20-point lead. How many times in this day and age, Jared, you get a 20-point lead, you score 46 points and a half, and you've only made one three? Doesn't happen very often.
No, no. Well, this is Doug Ogle's worst nightmare, is what it really turns out to be, because I think he felt like if he could slow the game down, stay within, let's say, the 10-point margin, Dan, he had a shot at it, but right now he has really got an uphill struggle.
Well, he wanted it in the 40s.
Yeah.
And I told you Doug Mitchell wanted it in the 40s.
At halftime.
At halftime.
a break. We'll come back. Second half tip-off is just a matter of minutes away here on the Indiana Cable Network. The team numbers in the first half. Top scorers for North Central, 16 for Devontae Smith-Rivera, 13 for Terone Johnson. For Warsaw, their top scorer, Nick Moore, despite getting bumped around, as Dan has pointed out on a number of occasions, he still had 14 points, including a 10-point second quarter. I know, Dan, from a coaching standpoint, you say, okay, let's do it in increments, but, well, that's going to be tough.
Yeah, you do. You say, okay, let's cut it 4 points in the first 3 minutes. Let's cut another 4 points in the next 3 minutes, things like that.
And then they come up and throw one up like that, and Ronnie Johnson gets the bucket, and all of a sudden you're down by 22.
Ronnie Johnson is a tremendous point guard. Doug Mitchell talked about him as an absolute Division I prospect. Doug coached at Butler. He understands what a Division I prospect is. He's coached a ton of them. He's absolutely right. Ronnie Johnson's one of those kids that just makes teams better, makes the guys around him shoot a high percentage, fun to be around, energy.
Terone Johnson off of the rebound now for North Central. They come all the way up, get the layup. But the biggest problem Doug Mitchell's going to have right now is to keep his ball club from getting sloppy.
Yeah, he is. And, you know, it's a mature group, as evidenced by how they've handled the playing time situation. You know, I'd like to really, Jerry, I've really liked the fact that they haven't shot any jump shots here to start the half, Earl.
I thought somebody had stepped in for a moment.
I don't know why. I thought I was on Letterman.
Stupid pet tricks. That's what we feel like.
Stupid
right
human
now.
Tricks.
It's been an interesting evening. Of course, you've been here all day long, and you've got to be talking to yourself.
Are you kidding me? I'll take two more. This is good fun, Jerry.
Right.
You had this all figured out starting in 1979. Get paid to come to the state finals.
Terone Johnson's first free throw of the game. 14 points down.
You're a legend. I mean, people come by.
Oh, yeah.
They drop off gift certificates to dinners and places, names.
A lot of those people I owe money to.
I was going to say that.
In fact, the governor hit me up, but I don't know what I owe it in. Here's Moore. Nice looking shot outside. Nick now with the second three-pointer. He had 17 points.
Nick Moore is just a really good-looking player.
Yeah. Now, Doug said Monday, he said, you're going to like watching this kid.
And
he's right, yeah.
It's a WWE match.
It is. It's one of the ugliest games you've seen for a while. They just continue to get bullet passes down inside, and they come up with the bucket. Here's Micah Smith getting his first 2 points of the game. And we pointed out before the game even began, that started the telecast, that North Central will go 10, 11, 12 players deep. They just continue to run people off. And Doug made reference to that at halftime when you were talking with him.
He said it very clearly. We have a lot of good players.
Yep.
And he's right, and I'll say this also. They have a lot of good coaches on that staff, because Doug Mitchell can coach the game of basketball as well as anybody.
You know, he had a good coach, Basil Smotherman, who was on his staff for 16 years and left his Nick Moore gets the bucket. His son was enrolled at Heritage Christian, and Basil took the head coaching job over there. So
smart on both counts, because his son's a pretty good basketball player.
Yep, but he's got some good guys on there. Walt Morris, Fred Andrews, Michael Elliott, Jeremy Simpson, they all work for it.
Well, Walt Morris, a terrific head coach at Buff.
So they've got the experience over there, and right now the players are buying into their act. Big high rebound for Jordan Kuhn. He is averaging about 3.5 a game, and Warsaw then turns the ball back over. And he'll get the bucket. Bob Terone Johnson. 54-31.
I'm going to take issue with our statistician, because right now Ronnie Johnson has 4 assists, according to the stats. I'm not buying that. Now, maybe he's making the pass, then the next pass is the assist. Maybe that's it. But Ronnie Johnson has set up a lot of guys in this basketball game.
And again, only a sophomore.
Yeah. Terrific. Plays with his head up, in control.
Well, the Warsaw fans came down, and I'm delighted to see that, because that's not an easy drive. In fact, I was driving down today. I got behind a van with the Warsaw license plate on it. And You know, I know that they came down as they get the bucket from Patrick Ingram. They came down with the thoughts of winning a state championship as well. They should have. I'm just not sure the people around the state knew just exactly how good this North Central club was. That young man, I do know how good he is right now. Nick Moore's got all the points here in the third quarter. North Central began the year as one of the top-rated clubs. They were number three in the AP poll. The basketball coaches, strangely enough, which ranks them without class.
Another one for Nick Moore.
Had him number two in the state. They finished up third in the AP poll and in second of the basketball coaches poll. Statistically, number two in the state in offensive average to Bowman Academy, whom you had earlier today.
Here we're going to see Nick Moore come off a little ball screen. Again, anytime Nick Moore has been able to free himself of a hand, a grab, another defender running at him, he's automatic. But those times have been few and far between.
Good point. North Central's defensive average is under 56 points a game.
Well, to your point, Jerry, they lost by four at Carmel. They lost by two to East Chicago Central. And then they lost by another two at Santa Grove. So this is a team very close to being undefeated on the season.
They did. North Central and Lawrence North have a terrific rivalry. And they laid a number on Lawrence North back at the Marion County Tournament. They beat them 59-55. And then they came out and beat them after the tournament 99-55.
You know,
that's a good Lawrence North team.
I got home from a game, and it was on with Hometown Sports. I couldn't wait to see it. It was 30.
Timeout with 3:50 to go now in the third quarter of play. And I was talking, you and I were talking about that 99 points they put on the board against Lawrence North, which is a very good ball club. Terone Johnson in that game scored the first 19 points in the game, and they outscored LN 28-8 in the third quarter of that contest.
Like I said, I came home, Jerry, and I was thinking, all right, I'll watch. I don't know if it was tape delayed or whatever it was, and it was 30. And I watched, and I thought, can this be right? Because as you said, Lawrence North, a tremendous team. A couple kids going to go to Louisville, a Chandler kid, really improved, big kid.
Well, then, Dan, in the sectional, they beat Lawrence North in the championship 41-30. They were down 19-7, they being North Central, after the first quarter, and they gave up 11 points the rest of the way, 5 in the second, 4 in the third, and 2 in the fourth quarter of that game.
Well, watching this game, it makes you wonder which 5 we're in.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. Nice play by Gross. He has 9 now. Out of bounds to Warsaw. Warsaw, on the other hand, lost only twice this year. They lost their third game of the year by a dozen at Fort Wayne South, and then they lost a game at Mackey Arena to Noblesville, 53-47, so they lost two games by a total of 18 points.
And Noblesville, a very good basketball team. Had a chance to see them a couple times. Fort Wayne Southside, we were here last year. Is that who limits in Southfield? No, Fort Wayne Snyder, I'm sorry. Ray Simpson's team.
And a bumping foul that should be on Nick Moore.
You know, you sit there as a coach. Fans from the other team are saying to Doug Mitchell, you know, play your reserves. You're sitting there thinking, well, you know what? 3.5 minutes to go. I know we're up 22, but this time about 20 years ago, there was a comeback against us. And
flashback.
It never leaves you. Ever.
Foul is on Moore. Number two on Nick. You're really not happy till the final buzzer sound.
You're really not.
Moore's going to get it across, fire the three, and knock it down. Boy, this kid is something else. In the semi-state championship against Carroll of Fort Wayne, they beat him 58-53. Moore had 26 points. As the basket is by Blewett, three-pointer for him. He hit 9 out of 12 from the field in that game, and it's a semi-state title game.
Think about that. Your point guard, who's asked to do everything, scores 26 points but only takes 12 shots.
Yeah.
Now, that's efficiency. That's production.
Here's Gross getting inside, missing the shot. Rebound off into the hands of Tripp McFall.
Tripp McFall's played a terrific game today.
Walking foul against North Central. Well, this is 100 years of Indiana high school basketball, but this the game so far will not be one they'll put in the time capsule.
No, and Doug Mitchell absolutely going crazy down on the other end, up 22. Doesn't matter. You want every call, as you said. You're not happy until that buzzer sounds, but this game has been... How would you best describe this game? You're the wordsmith.
Well,
how would you best... You said ragtag, is that...
I think I didn't say ragtag, but that's a pretty good description, yes. Gross gets the bucket. You know, it's,
I don't mean for that to take away from what North Central's doing.
No.
North Central's terrific basketball team.
It actually is kind of the game that North Central would love to have. Warsaw is doing nothing wrong. They're just getting whooped right now. It's just that simple. They're not making any particular glaring errors. They're just being outgunned and outmanned at almost every position, except for Nick Moore, who's just having a terrific game. And a foul will be against Warsaw. It was just one of those games, Dan, and I think you and I both felt this at the outset of the game, as the foul again is on Nick Moore, and that's going to be 3 on him. If Warsaw got behind by a substantial amount, they were going to really struggle to get back into the ball game. That's exactly what's happened.
You know, we talked about it earlier. Doug Ogle said, hey, I want this in the 40s.
Yep.
They didn't play that way to start the game.
No, they did
That's
not.
The problem.
Taco Bell, for every free throw made today, donating $10 up to $500 to the IHSAA Centennial Scholarship Award. Well, you and I made comment about that. That was the way the game started was not what I anticipated. I'll put it that way.
No, it really wasn't. And you wonder if that didn't get in his team's mindset, hey, we can run, we can play with these guys, which is, I'm guessing, not what they worked on all week, according to the comments that we have heard.
Here's the basket by Justin Clemens. First time Justin's been on the scorebook now since the first quarter of the game. And the foul will be on Tripp McFall, number 3 on him.
I'm going to tell you what, the Warsaw kids haven't given up.
Nope.
And the Warsaw fans surely haven't given up. These people are still standing. They're still here. They're still loud. Good for them.
You know, they fill the entire arena behind us on the lower level. And if you look across the way, there's people over there that are wearing
the upper level, lower
Warsaw colors.
Yeah, they took over the Gary Wallace section behind their own bench.
So they have backed this ball club. And why not, when you're 23-2, as they are? You are a little shocked at what is transpiring on the floor. They were ranked number 6 by the AP, and the Indiana basketball coaches had them ranked number 11 in the state. So they're a darn good ball club. This is a club that was 19-3 last year and got beat by Elkhart Memorial in the sectional.
This game's back to 17. With the ball, they've cut into this lead.
Yeah, it was 23.
You and I have been chatting, and they've cut in here pretty good. Crowd still involved, 3 on the way.
Well, as we pointed out, you know, they start 2 sophomores, so 19 wins last year, 23 this year so far. And the future looks still very bright for this Warsaw team.
Yeah, it really does. And you know, to your point, we've talked about Nick Moore, and he is terrific, but these other kids, I think these other kids really know how to play. Jordan Kuhn, Lucas Gross, all be back, sophomores, terrific.
Free throw is good by Johnson. That foul, by the way, on Moore gives him 4. Now, what do? You take him out? He's still out there.
Yeah, I think you have to. I think maybe you have to take him out for a minute. But you know what? State finals game. No, you just leave him in. I mean, what are you going to do?
Yeah.
Play his own. Hope he's smart enough to understand. My guess is he really is. Right here. You have to stop, pull up.
Well,
their energy. You got to love their energy, and you got to respect their heart here.
Well, he's just having a terrific third quarter of play. He has six field goals, and two of those six are three-pointers. Final minute of the third period, 64-47. From behind, nice play by Zach Linke. Right out front, basket will be wiped off, traveling violation. Warsaw statistically 44th in the state in average win margin. During the regular season, they had only three wins by less than 10 points. Their average win margin over the regular season was 13 points a game. Got down to just under six during the tournament, as I pointed out earlier. They had a tough time in their sectional, regional, and semi-state. They won them all, but by 2, 5, 8, 9, and 5. They didn't run away from anybody.
And they played some terrific programs. Maribor with Jimmy's, a terrific basketball program. Mike Hackett at Munster has those kids playing at the Munster way in seventh grade. And there's Nick Moore.
He had 14 points in the first half. He had 14 points in the third quarter. 28 points.
Coach took a gamble.
Yep.
Calculated gamble, because really you were not going to win this game, and that's what you're here to do. You're here to win this game. Early in the season, hey, let's see how we play, maybe take a moral victory. No, no, not here. And in defending Coach Ogle for keeping him in, down 17, well, you were not going to win this game.
I don't think you had a choice, Dan. Do you?
No, I really. You always have a choice as a coach, and you always second guess yourself. You know, fans may second guess you as a coach, but nobody. And I'm telling you, nobody second guesses like a coach to himself. So
this kid has hugged everybody on that side of the arena. It shows you how.
And they've hugged him.
I was just going to say, that shows you how much love is coming back to him. Terrific player. 3-point field goal is good, Ronnie Johnson. That's his third field goal in the quarter, two of which have been 3-pointers. He has 32 of those on the year. 20 seconds to go now in the third, 67-47. That's a nice looking move by Clemens. Justin had 4 points in the first quarter, did not score in the second, has put up 5 here in the third. They bank it off the glass and get the bucket just prior to the buzzer. And Blewett gets the bucket, 5 points in the quarter, 7, and that's going to take care of the third quarter of our 4A championship game. Group 3, 20-point ball game, 69-49, North Central over Warsaw. Along with Dan Dockets, this is Jerry Baker. We're delighted to have you along tonight for this 4A championship game.
When did these things start? I love these things. Can they come? Oh, I wish they could have held the camera there. Kind of a unison cheer.
I'll tell you what.
We missed it.
One of the things that when you go to a game, high school game, I'm always interested to see what the fans are going to do. They're very clever. They're very clever.
I was at a Park Tudor game this year. They're up 14-0. Baby powder on the first basket. It drifted down. Next thing you know, at about 12-0, it was starting to get slippery. They had to stop the game.
Clean it up.
Clean it up. It did not help Park Tudor in that basketball game against Chitara.
It is it's fun to watch the fans get involved in that kind of a spirit.
It's great. When students are involved, it makes the entire environment.
Yeah. And I'm happy to see it with North Central. A lot of times, man, as you well know, a good-looking shot from outside from Zach Linke, his first field goal. Some of the big schools kind of lose that camaraderie, if you will.
Absolutely. And glad to see you mentioned it. North Central looking over there, a ton of kids.
Yeah.
Of course, they have a ton of kids in the
school.
Yeah,
they do. Yeah, over 3,000 there, sure. Here's the foul on Andy Conrad, number one on him.
Pretty nice little move, Zach Linke. Kid playing in his last high school basketball game, drilling a three.
Take a look at the numbers through three quarters of play here.
The only thing that jumps out to me, Dave, I keep calling you Dave, Jerry. We've been together for two games, 21 turnovers. 21 turnovers equals points for North Central. Some teams turn you over, they don't score out of it. North Central absolutely does. I have the Dave thing figured out. I'll tell you why here in a minute.
I can't light them down as fast as they're moving up and down the court. You just turn, you turn your head away for a second, and all of a sudden, boom, you got two more buckets on the board. 19-point ball game is what it turns out to be. 73-54. It's not been a thing of beauty, but you got to give North Central credit because they wanted this to be an ugly game.
Yeah.
And Warsaw, give them credit on the fact that they just, they're still out there plugging away, man.
And their students and their parents and their fans are the same. There is so much pride in a place like Warsaw, school like North Central. Went to the Joe Deslin dinner at Cathedral last year and spoke. And when I walked in there, you could just feel the pride in the school. You know, you saw it today with Gary Lou Wallace.
Yeah.
You know, you just see so much pride when you come to these things and all of the schools. It's just, it's fantastic to see.
Both free throws are good by Gross, giving him 13 points. Oh, Wallace played a whale of a game, didn't he? The 3A championship.
I wonder what Cody Zeller's doing right now. Oh. I'm guessing he ate. 20 ice bags, maybe.
Oh,
different areas.
Well, they had to get 20 ice bags for 20 different players because everybody was on the floor in that game. It's one of the most physical games that you and I pointed out I have ever seen, and by no means dirty. Let's understand. That was a good-looking shot from Ronnie Johnson.
Ronnie Johnson has had a super basketball game.
It's the third three-pointer for him. He has 13 points. He came in averaging 9.4 and leading the team in assists with an average of over three per game. 6.5 to go.
You said it, only a sophomore. Terone Johnson, only a sophomore. Latham, only a freshman. Think they'll be around?
Yeah. I think Doug Mitchell's not taking a good long look at their future. Jordan Kuhn. First couple of points for Jordan. He's only a sophomore for Warsaw. All alone under the hoop. Basket is good by Latham, giving him 9 points in the game.
This entire game, and we talked about it in the first half, Jerry, the interior passing. Doug Mitchell, I'm going to ask him after the basketball game, was there a concerted effort? Did they see something in scouting that enabled them to slip behind Warsaw's defense? Because this isn't something that happened once, twice, three times. This is something that's been going on all game. Latham there, snuck behind the defense. Those are things that coaches see in film sessions. They show to their players, going out, if they did show in film session, the players were executing beautifully.
Latham completes the three-point play. Darius, 4-for-4 from the line, having a nice ball game. He has 10 points. His average is only 4.2. 2 minutes gone, fourth quarter, been all North Central. They're up 79-58. They've led by as many as 23. Looking at Gross has 10 rebounds. He's got himself a double-double right now. 15 points, 10 rebounds.
Lucas Gross is a great-looking player.
Yeah, he is.
He's tall. He's broad-shouldered. You know, he has a great look in his eyes. Like, I'm going to be a player. Not I want to be a player, but I'm going to be a player. And has great anticipation as well. I don't know if he can shoot it like Pops, man.
That 10 man can. That's Terone Johnson's second three of the game. He has 22. That's right at his scoring norm of 21 threes. Conrad, left side. Yeah, nice play by Andy.
Good shot fake. Had a lot of poise, a lot of patience right there. Step up, knock it in.
3 minutes into the fourth quarter. North Central is trailed only once in this ball game. They were down by as many as four early on, and then once they retook the lead, they just never looked back.
Jerry, this game did start out great for North Central.
No, it did not.
I mean, it was started out pretty good for Warsaw.
We'll get a timeout with 4:40 to go, and we'll do the same. It's a 24-point ball game with North Central leading Warsaw for the 4A championship. Well, many of this crowd of 18,000 plus have headed for the exits. as North Central has simply taken over this ball game and just been dominant right from the get-go. They led 19-12 after one, had a 20-point lead at halftime, 46-26, 20 points after three, 69-49, and now they're up by 24 points. North Central shooting 55% on 32 of 58. Warsaw shooting 53.5% on 23 of 43.
74% in the second half. Back cut here.
Gross got inside, had the ball deflected and knocked out of bounds, and last touch by Terone Johnson. Kind of goes along, Dan, with what I was saying. Warsaw still playing hard, giving 100%. They're just up against the ball club. It's just super.
You know, sometimes, quite frankly, you just play a team that's better.
Yeah, yeah.
Period. I mean, all the scouting, all the work, everything else. Well, you know what? North Central does the same thing. They're just better tonight.
Gross with here. A nice, strong effort to the hoop. Gets the bucket. And the foul's going to be on Latham. That'll be four on him.
I really like Gross. We talked about it before the break. But
I've got him for 18 points right now. 18 points, 10 rebounds. Nice double-double.
Well, these sophomores, we've mentioned in the past, I mean, he's a kid that certainly with Nick Moore back and he back, wouldn't be a surprise to see them back here next year. Tough teams they play, though. Maryville, really good basketball team. Munster, really good. I happen to see Carroll play Zionsville. They beat Zionsville. Zionsville, outstanding.
Here's some pretty good names right here. The All-Century team, Indiana High School basketball. Alford, Bailey, Benson, Bird, Bland. How'd you like to have those guys
in? Good start. How about the year Steve Alford had? Mike Conley, Billy Garrett, Terry Dischinger, Eric Gordon, Billy Keller.
Terry Dischinger out of Terre Haute Garfield. How about the Rocket, Rick Mount on there? Bobby Plump, of course, will be known forever. Clyde LaBellet. Out of Terre Haute Garfield. There was a time when Garfield, Gerstmeyer, Wiley over in the Terre Haute area. Man, they had some great athletes.
Where was Arlie Harley and Uncle Harry?
Arlie
Gerstmeyer?
Yes, Terre Haute Gerstmeyer.
Zach Randolph, Jimmy Rail, the big dog in there with the big O.
Scott Skiles, forever will go down in history of that Plymouth championship.
Ronaldo Thomas has had his heart broke twice in state championship finales, once by Scott Skiles and once by Washington.
Here are the Van Arsdales out of Manual.
Nice move.
Oh, there's some great names on there. It gives you an indication of the kind of players that have gone through the basketball programs in the state of Indiana. I commend the IHSAA for putting on this 100 years, 100 days. That was a big-time effort.
Yeah, a lot of fun.
Three-pointer by Jordan Kuhn. Kuhn, with his 10th of the year, is first of the game. He has 5 points. And just like that, they come back to the other end and get another bucket, this time out of Terone Johnson. So he has 5 in the quarter. Give him 24 on the night.
I think Todd Mitchell wants one more basket, and then he's going to start taking guys out here. Let's see.
Well, Mitchell is really upset.
Boy, he is.
I mean, he threw the towel down. He is extremely irate. It's aimed toward Ronnie Johnson. I don't know what Ronnie did exactly, but he's coming out of the ball game along with Darius Latham.
Told you, you're only happy in 3 minutes and 7 seconds. I missed what he did. He jumped in the air, made a little no-look pass, put the freshman in a bad spot. Not the best decision Ronnie Johnson has made.
Well, they gave it the ball to him in a position he couldn't do anything
right
with it, I guess.
Yeah,
is what
in a bad
Doug
spot
was upset about. But
the other thing about
he
that
is still upset.
He's just told his entire team, hey, nobody's relaxing. Not yet.
Well, there's 3 minutes to go, and your ball club is up by 22.
I'm telling you, one time it happened to him.
I know.
One time, 15 years ago, somebody banged in 5 threes against him in the last minute.
This is
coaches, don't forget.
4A record, 90 points. Gross missing from point blank range, but they managed to steal. Then it's getting right back to North Central.
I was going to say, if I was Bass, the kid that replaced Ronnie Johnson, I'd give it up quick. Get rid of it.
Literally, if I want to stay out here, I'm not going to hang on to this one long. tell you, the thing I like about Warsaw, thing I like about Warsaw right now, they have not thrown in the towel at all.
A lot of heart. A lot of heart, a lot of character. Great pass by Terone Johnson.
Now to Tripp McCall, who gets the bucket, and we're heading toward the two-minute mark. And he fouled from behind.
If I don't get a chance to say it, Jared, it's been an absolute thrill to sit here for two basketball games. We've had a lot of laughs here.
My pleasure, my friend. I want to thank Jason Willey, who's the sports information director for the IHSAA, because it's a lot of time and effort getting all this information together. It saves us a lot of digging and phone calls and things like that.
You know, just seeing Jason, you can see how much he cares about making sure that everybody on this row and the row behind this media row has everything that they need. It's a real passion.
Having worked there, I know the hours that go into that. Chris Kaufman, likewise, our thanks to Chris, who's also been a very big factor in putting all of the 100 years and 100 days together. Our thanks to them and all the staff of the High School Athletic Association. Turned out that the 4A game has been perhaps the weakest of the four today. You had a couple of good ones this morning, even though one of the scores was somewhat lopsided. I was interested to watch that Bowman Academy team. That's an interesting scenario they've got up there with that being a charter school, and that's created some interest up in the region.
Well, it has, but you know, I was talking at lunch with a couple friends of mine from Northwest Indiana, and they said, you know what, when you went to Holy Angels last year, which is where Bowman Academy was, they built a new building. The parents were very supportive. The kids were yes sir, no sir. There was a ton of discipline in the school. Now, I understand that, you know, people have had conversations, good, bad, happy, or sad about it, but from an academic standpoint, again, I've never been there. I'm just going by what a couple of people that I respect to say. Pretty impressive place from an academic and a discipline standpoint. Yeah, man, right on time here. Our guy.
There's Jason right there. Dropping off some notes.
Well, let me ask you, what were your impressions of Bowman Academy? You've watched some of the great teams. I mean, how good do you think that team was?
You know, somebody said they wish this was a year where they're single classes so that they could play against everybody. I think sometimes you're careful what you wish for.
Sure.
I think in their classification, based on what I saw, I don't think anybody's going to touch them for a while.
Yeah, they play really hard.
Yeah.
Marvin Ray, good story, won the Trestor Award, now he wins the state championship. A lot of Ron Heflin influence. You remember Ron?
I sure do.
Ron coached Ronaldo Thomas. He coached Marvin Ray. Great coach at Gary Roosevelt High School.
North Central just going into a little bit of a fly pattern, stalling pattern right now. Still, Terone Johnson comes up with the bucket. He's got a 26-point game going. I hope to get a dead ball here because there's a bunch of guys on the far side that want to get in. Good looking shot from long range by Zach Linke. And we'll get a timeout to get some of the subs in there. Give them a chance to put their name in the scorebook.
It's always a great scene when seniors come out. They've won a state championship. Great scene here.
Yeah, Warsaw crowd.
Yeah. I was looking over there, seeing Terone Johnson hugging Walt Morris, guy we mentioned, Doug Mitchell. It's always a great scene, but you know what? I'll tell you, I have a lot of respect for Warsaw, don't you? I mean, the crowd, the people, we keep talking about it, but boy, looking around, they're here. They haven't left, they're up. Kids have continued to fight. Hey, sometimes it doesn't go your way, but that doesn't mean you shouldn't fight. And these kids have absolutely fought. And fought.
95 points on the board for North Central. They put 112 on the board in one game. They had 99 in another, 98 in another as they go down the list, 97 in the last game of the year, 82 against Jeffersonville on the Southport semi-state. Awfully good ball club. And one of the issues, Dan, is they don't meet each other. So from our standpoint, people in the South or in the North, we really don't know how good they are or are not. And I think a lot of people might have underestimated this North Central team.
Well, I think you're absolutely right. I really don't know how, though. You know, we talked about Smith-Rivera, a kid that's being recruited. We talked about Terone Johnson. You know, I'm guessing, you know, thinking about Ronnie Johnson, probably four Division I players on this basketball team. But you said it, Indianapolis. It's tough.
It is.
I mean, it's tough.
It's tough.
Noblesville. Noblesville, one-point game in overtime with North Central.
Sometimes the semi-state is tougher than the state.
Sometimes the sectional is tougher than the state.
That's going to take care of things. The game is over. North Central just absolutely dominant in this game as they win it by a final score of 95-74. We break when we come back. Presentation of the trophies and all the other post-game festivities. And so with the final score, North Central 95, Warsaw 74, the Panthers of North Central High School finish up the 2009-2010 season 25-3. Warsaw falls to 23-3 in the runner-up role. Back with more of the activities here at Conseco Fieldhouse as we'll hand out the silver, the runner-up awards and the state championship. Back at Conseco Fieldhouse, Jeff Penrod, member of the board of directors for the High School Athletic Association out of Columbia City, has just announced that Justin Clemens of Warsaw is the Trester Award winner. And we'll come back momentarily and have a chance, hopefully, to have a chat with Justin Clemens. Our postgame festivities presented by the Indiana Farm Bureau, the Indiana Farm Bureau Medal Attitude Award being handed out to Justin Clemens, and here is a good look at Justin.
Nobody sells more Hyundais than Ray.
Coming up onto the podium, had a 9-point ball game. Big 6'3 senior. It's a tough situation when you're the Trester Award winner and you're on the losing side of the scoreboard. But our congrats going out to Justin Clemens and his family.
Your head coach, Doug
Mogul. Dan, I think you've got some of the folks around Justin.
I do. I have Gordy and Dana Clemens now. Justin won the Trester Award. Congratulations. I can only imagine how proud you are.
Oh, we are very proud. Justin's just been one of those gifted kids all of his life, and he's made parenting very easy.
Well, Gordy, you said it. Dana's the best athlete in the family. You got to go a long way because Justin's a pretty good basketball player.
Justin's a heck of an athlete, but his mother is the boss of our house. She's the athlete. He got it all from her, and he's just a beautiful person inside. He got that from her, but he got his good looks from me.
The word on the street is you do an unbelievable Elvis imitation. That's what I'm hearing, Gordy.
I'm going to leave that one alone.
Well, but really, you know, this is the fourth game, and I've interviewed all the parents. This is really an emotional moment for you. I'm guessing you understand the significance of the Trester Award.
Oh, without a doubt. I mean,
we've been associated with Indiana basketball for many years, and we know the importance of this award and what an honor it is, and we just feel very blessed that they felt Justin to deserve this award.
He's a beautiful person. Both of our fathers are looking down right now, loving every second of this, and he's just a very deserving kid. I know there's a lot of them, but he is an incredible boy. We're so proud.
I really appreciate your time. Congratulations. This awesome year.
Thanks, Dan.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.
We'll go back to you. Justin's going to get with his teammates, take some pictures.
All right, Dan. I told you she was the best athlete in the family. You wouldn't listen to me. Quick look at the scoring for North Central. They were led by Terone Johnson with 26. He had a terrific ball game. That's about five above his scoring average. 17 from Ronnie Johnson, 16 from Devontae Smith-Rivera. All of those in first half, by the way. And 14 from Darius Latham for Warsaw. 28 from Nick Moore, who fouled out of the fourth quarter. He had a 14-point first half and then a 14-point third quarter. Some kind of a player. 18 for Lucas Groves and 10 for Zach Linke. Let's go back out now again to Dan. Dan?
Well, Doug, congratulations. Tremendous effort by your kids tonight.
You know, I just think we're a little deeper than they were, and I think our depth finally took its toll on them as the game went on. I think as much defensively at their end as anything. Yeah, they kept shooting the ball in. They wouldn't go away offensively, but I think defensively they had a hard time staying in front of us.
Was it something you saw in scouting, but your interior passing was outstanding? Is that something you saw you could exploit with Warsaw? Or the kids figure that out?
Yeah, we did. I mean, it's a matchup zone, and it's very good, but if you cut crisply, we figured it was a foot race to the ball, and we'd win that, and I think we did a few times.
Golf season with a state championship, not a bad deal, Doug.
Not a bad deal. It's golf season now, Doc.
Congratulations. Happy
you.
For you. Back to you, Bank.
Doug Mitchell, that is his second championship. He won it all back in 99 in 4A, defeating Elkhart Central 79-74. They went 23-5 that year. They were runners-up in 07 to East Chicago Central. Final again, 95-74. Another break. Many of the sellout crowd filing out of Conseco Fieldhouse. A lot of the North Central fans sticking around after watching their ball club win over Warsaw 95-74. Let's get down to the Taco Bell player of the game. Many to choose from, Dan, but let's go with 32, Terone Johnson.
Well, as good as any, Terone Johnson, 26 points, knocked in a couple threes, 10 of 18 from the field. Also, got 8 assists in this basketball game. You heard Doug Mitchell say, we were looking underneath the zone, inside the zone. Terone Johnson was big for making the feed.
So Terone Johnson is our Taco Bell player of the game. Congrats to him and the rest of the Panthers coming off that big win, 95-74 for the 4A championship.
You know, it was neat out there, and we mentioned it.
Let's move ahead now to the Comcast high-speed play of the game, of which, again, many to choose from tonight.
Which one you want? Terone Johnson gets it back, lays it in. Terrific, terrific pass here. Outstanding pass by Smith-Rivera.
And again, Doug pointed out, they just keep throwing people at you. They just feel like they're going to wear you out. It's funny, the numbers, of the paint numbers, of course, are significant. Points off turnovers likewise, fast break points, everything falls into the winning category for the winning team.
You know, 58 points is a lot of points to score in a game from anywhere, but 58 points strictly in the paint was terrific. And again, the interior passing outstanding, getting out in transition, finishing around the rim, all outstanding for a really powerful North Central basketball team.
And again, Dan, to reiterate, we talked about Ronnie Johnson, a sophomore, is a starter. They also started a freshman, Darius Latham. They started another sophomore in Devontae Smith-Rivera. Doug's got to be licking his chops for next year already.
Yeah, you know, Doug's licking his chops for two things. Number one, he gets to go golfing because that's his thing. And number two, he knows this summer's going to be fun. He's going to play in the different events that you do with your high school team, and he knows he has a terrific basketball team coming back. They'll miss Terone Johnson, though. Terone Johnson, when you watch your basketball team, he's a guy. Kind of settles them down, can do a lot of things.
Well, it's been a fun day here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Our congrats to all of the state champions. Our thanks to Dan Donkich. And our thanks to the Indiana Basketball Hall of Fame for all of their help today in the footage of the various teams and their selection of the all-century teams and things of that nature. Our thanks to them. This is Jerry Baker for Dan and the rest of our crew. Matt, our director, producer. Final score again, 95-74. Good night now from Conseco Fieldhouse.